Welcome to the channel. In this video, I want to talk about a truck that you can actually afford. I know a lot of people complain about the pricing of trucks when you're looking at your XLTs, your Lariats, your Platinums. And as the trim goes up, the prices get insane. A lot of people don't like the idea that these trucks are $60,000, $70,000. In this video, I want to talk about a truck you can actually afford. This is our 2019 F-250. It's got the gas engine and it's got the STX package. Now, the STX package is one of those trucks that is affordable, but it's still well equipped. So really, what the sacrifices that you make going with one of these packages is you're not going to get fog lights like you do on an XLT. The wheels, they're not quite as nice as the XLT, but you really wouldn't notice. In 2020, they have a different wheel. They're always updating the wheels, but to me, they look like pretty decent wheels. They look like a higher trim level, and this is just an XL truck, technically. Now, another sacrifice you make with the Fords is you just have black paneling here, black B-pillar appliques here, and a lot of people complain about that, but a lot of people really don't like the new polished B-pillar appliques because they just attract scratches. The amount of work that this truck has seen and the amount of abuse that this truck has seen, these B-pillar appliques still look brand new. So you can make the argument that the B-pillar appliques being just matte black are actually better than having those polished ones. But you'd also lose that keypad. And I'm sure somehow you can get the keypad, but I don't know exactly how. Moving forward inside the truck, you also lose the power seat, so you're making a sacrifice there, which is not a big deal, but I wish there was a way that you can manually go up and down with the seat, because when I'm plowing snow, it can be hard to see. I mean, I've gotten used to it, but it'd be nice if the seat can go up, because if someone's short and they're trying to plow and they can't see what they're doing. But you know, manual is cool, but it'd be nice if it can go up and down. But yeah, you really gotta slide the seat, which is maybe a deal breaker for some. It doesn't bother me. I actually like that the lumbar is mechanical because it's actually quicker for me just to pop this lumbar and to swing this seat back instead of waiting for the electric motor to slowly lower it back. It goes real slow, whereas this, you just pull the lever, push yourself back, and you can recline a lot quicker. So I do like the idea of a mechanical lumbar, but even if it were mechanical, some kind of way of going up and down would be good. Another thing is you got the hard plastic steering wheel. Now, it's hard to get into a leather steering wheel. Even just an XLT package, you still don't necessarily get a leather steering wheel. You still end up with a plastic steering wheel, a lot of XLT trims. So I actually like the plastic steering wheel because when you're out there plowing for hours and hours and hours, the leather would be destroyed very quickly from plowing. So in my opinion, the plastic steering wheel is better just because of the fact that it's more durable. With this package, you also are not going to get a big center console, but this is okay in my opinion because I do use this seat from time to time. So I actually prefer to have it like this, not with the big center console. Like if I want to hang out with my kid in the truck, not driving around or anything, but just in the yard or whatever, we're playing with the plow or whatever, he wants to play with the remote, he can sit here in the middle, and it's just nice, you know, to have that little seat there for whenever. It does technically have a purpose. It can seat more people. With the big center console, that's just something that you can't sit anyone there. But at the end of the day, this truck is still well equipped, even though it's an XL. It still has a full touchscreen. It still has full power windows. It still has automatic headlights. It still has a trailer brake control, electronic shift on the fly. It still has USB inputs, Bluetooth. Now, we don't get dual climate or anything. You don't get heated seats. But you'd be surprised. You can really get by without all that fancy stuff. Just basic, you know, amenities. Nothing crazy. You know, you'd be surprised. No heated steering wheel, no heated seats. But at the end of the day, this truck is an affordable truck. This truck is something like $53,000 with the plow on it, and it's an income-earning vehicle compared to the Platinums and everything, where you can be into an $80,000 truck that doesn't really, do anything. This truck, I think the price of it out the door is about $50,000, and then you start adding on like the plow, and it's still less than some of the higher trim level trucks. Now in this package, you could get a diesel if you wanted a diesel. You could get that. That wouldn't be an issue. It would be a lot more money, but it wouldn't be too big a deal. It'd be another $10,000. Probably be a $60,000 truck. But I would have to look at the build sheet to know. But these Exhale trucks with the SCX packages are really nice. I would daily drive it any day of the week and not have any problems. But comment below. Tell me what you think. Do you think these are good values, or do you think that it's better to go for like a Platinum or something like that, or an XLT? Essentially, an XLT is going to give you a power seat. It's going to give you heated seats if you get the high trim level, the top level XLT, not your entry level XLT. But if you go for a high level XLT, you can get heated seats. I think it's like a $3,000 package right now at the time of filming this video to get heated seats. You get power mirrors, But anyway, guys, thank you for watching. I gotta go. Have a great day. Hope to hear you in the comment section, and talk to you later. Bye.